हेलो क्लास 10th, वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर 1 ऑफ सिविक्स द यूनियन पार्लियामेंट. टुडेज टॉपिक्स आर फर्स्ट प्रिविलेजेस ऑफ द मेंबर्स ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट, नंबर 2 पार्लियामेंट्री प्रोसीजर्स. वी विल डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टुडेज टॉपिक आर फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच, फ्रीडम ऑफ मूवमेंट which comes under the topic number 1, oath, quorum, casting vote, question hour, zero hour, resolution, president's address, which comes under the topic number 2. Let's discuss the keywords. Number 1, entitled, it means grant. Number 2, detention, it means custody. Number 3, affirm, it means state. Number 4, allegiance, it means loyalty. Number 5, constitute, it means start. Number 6, resolution, it means firm decision. Number 7, commencement, it means start. Now students, open your books. Privileges of the members of the parliament. Privileges means benefit or freedom. The members of both the houses of the parliament, that is the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, are entitled. Entitled means allow or grant to certain privileges. They can be grouped under the following heads. The Constitution of India specifies some of the privileges or grant to the members of both the houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Freedom of speech. The members of the parliament have the freedom to speak out their views within as well as out of the parliament. They have also right to get their views published in the press. No proceedings means legal action can be initiated. Initiated means set up against them for whatever they say in the parliament. It allows members of the parliament to speak freely within or out of the parliament without any fear. They also have full freedom to publish their views in the press. No legal action can be taken against that, whatever they say in the parliament. Freedom of movement. The members of the parliament have a special freedom of movement during the session of the parliament. No member of the parliament can be kept in detention, means custody, even if any case of criminal nature is going on in a court of law against him. If at all the law demands his detention, it can only be done with the prior permission of the chairman of the house of which he happens to be a member. The members of both houses have a freedom of movement during the session of parliament. The member enjoys freedom from arrest in any civil case 40 days before and after the adjournment of the house, and also when the house is in session. No member can be arrested from the limits of the parliament. But in criminal case, a member can be arrested outside the limits of the house, but here the speaker or chairman should be informed. Parliamentary procedures. Parliamentary procedures are the formalities which the legislatures have to observe in the course of their functions. Some of the most common procedures observed by the Indian Parliament and also by the state legislatures are given as under. Parliamentary procedure is the body of rules, ethics, customs, governing meetings and other operations of clubs, organizations, legislative bodies and other deliberative assemblies. Oath. After the general elections or by-elections or mid-term elections, the duly elected members have to take the following oath. Oath means a promise about your behavior or actions. After the general elections or by-elections means an election held in a single political constituency to fill a vacancy arising during a government term of office, or mid-term elections means elections refers to where the people can elect their representatives in the middle of the term of executive, all the elected members have to take the following oath. It is the speaker who administers oath for the elected members. I, name of the member, having been elected or nominated a member of the Council of States or House of the People, do swear in the name of God solemnly. Affirm means state that I will be true, and owe means repay. Allegiance means loyalty to the Constitution of India as by law established, and that I will faithfully discharge the duty upon which I am about to enter. It is only after taking this oath that a member can take part in the proceedings of the House. An oath of office is an affirmation a person takes before assuming the duties of an office. Some oaths of office are a statement of loyalty to a constitution. Quorum. Quorum is the minimum number of members to be present in the House before it could transact any business. As per rule, 1/10 of the total membership of each House constitutes the quorum. The present strength of Lok Sabha is 545, hence 55 members constitute means start the quorum. The present strength of Rajya Sabha is 245, hence 25 members constitute means start the quorum. Quorum means the minimum number of members present at any of its meetings to make the proceedings of the meeting valid. As per rule, each House requires 1/10 of the total membership to transact any meetings. Lok Sabha requires 55 members and Rajya Sabha requires 25 members to constitute the quorum. Casting vote. The decision of the House are taken by a majority vote. But if there is a tie, that is, the votes for and against happen to be equal, the Speaker of the House has been given the power to cast his vote to make a decision. A vote by the Speaker is called the casting vote. Casting vote means an extra vote given by a chairperson to decide an issue when the votes on each side are equal. The Speaker does not vote in the first instance, but he can exercise a casting vote in the case of a tie. In the other words, only when the House is divided equally on any question, the Speaker is entitled to vote. Such vote is called casting vote, and its purpose is to resolve a deadlock. Question R. Every member of the House has the privilege to ask questions from the government on matter of public interest. Such questions are addressed to the chair, and if admitted, the government is obliged, means require, to answer them. First hour of every working day of the House is reserved for questions unless otherwise decided by the Speaker. Question hour is the first hour of a sitting session of India's Lok Sabha devoted to questions that members of the Parliament raise about any aspect of administrative activity. The concerned minister is obliged to answer to the Parliament either orally or in writing, depending on the type of question raised. There are three types of questions: unstirred questions, stirred questions, short notice questions. Unstirred questions have to be answered in a written form by the minister concerned. Stirred questions are answered orally on the floor of the House by the ministers concerned. Supplementary questions can also be asked. Short notice questions relating to a matter of urgent public importance can be asked with a prior notice of around 10 days. Unstirred questions. An unstirred question is one to which written answer is desired by the member. Stirred question. A stirred question is one to which a member desires an oral answer from the minister in the House and is required to be distinguished by him with a mark. The member is allowed to ask a supplementary question with the permission of Speaker. And the short notice question, A member may give a notice of question on a matter of public importance for oral answer at a notice less than 10 days. 0 hour. The time immediately following the question hour is known as the 0 hour. It starts at around 12 o'clock and members can raise issues of importance and ask questions. Usually, there is a lunch break at 1 p.m. The 0 hour, therefore, does not last for more than an hour. 0 hour means the time immediately following the question hour has come to be known as 0 hour. It starts at around 12 noon and members can, with prior notice to the speaker, raise issues of importance during this time. Resolution means firm decision. A resolution is a motion presented to the House on a matter of general public interest. A member must give 15 days prior notice for such a motion. The Speaker may allow a shorter period of notice. The majority opinion in the House on such a matter is called resolution of the House. Motions and resolutions are procedural device to raise a discussion in the House on a matter of general public interest. The term motion means any proposal submitted to the House for generating its decision. The decision which has been elicited means drawn out turns the motion into resolution. President's address. The President addressed the joint sitting of the two Houses at the commencement means start of the session, first session, after each general election. The President also addresses both House of the Parliament at the commencement of first session of each year, that is the budget session. After the general elections, the President starts the session by addressing the joint sitting of two Houses and also in the budget session. The President's address is a policy statement of the government. The address outlines the policies and programs of the government. The President's address is a policy statement of government means the declaration of government political activities, plans, etc. Thank you.